Hello everyone, this is Michael here, and I am one of the product managers at Syncfusion. And I see through the development of the database controls like chat, maps, gauges, tree map, etc. And here today to present what's new in our Essential Studio for Flutter platform in our Volume 4 2019 release. I'm really excited to share the new features for this release. So without further delay, let's dive into the agenda of this session. I have planned this session to point out the exciting new features in our Flutter charts and radial gauge, along with a demo on creating a new application in Flutter to try out our new calendar widget, which we have implemented in this release. And also provide you an overview on our new licensing model. So let's dive deep. In this release, we have introduced a new widget. That is the event calendar widget, and it is an interactive widget which provides basic functionality for scheduling, managing, and representing appointments efficiently. You can add appointments or events, you can add recurring appointments, you can customize the time zone, you can customize flexible working days, and you have options, and you also have options to customize its appearance as well. So this is the basic appearance that you are seeing in the slide, and I will show you a demo on this later. I will prepare a new application, and I will show you a demo on these tools. So the next set of features that I like to talk about from the chat, and it has some major enhancements this release with 7 new chart types like 100% stacked area, 100% stacked bar, 100% stacked column, 100% stacked line, spline area, a step area, and range area. You can see these are the chart types that are introduced in Flutter charts. We have also concentrated on the other customization features like support for delay and disappearance of crosshair and track wall. We also have support for displaying the tooltip at the pointer location. So whenever you click on a point, earlier what will happen is the tooltip will appear on the above of on the column series. Now you can see whenever you click on the particular point, the tooltip will appear on that particular point. So I will show you these things on the demo later. So the next set of features that I like to talk about are from radial gauge, and we have added a new few customization options like gradient support for scale and pointers. You can add background image for the axis, and now you have animation while loading the gauge. So as you can see here, this is the loading animation that we have provided for our radial flutter. So next, I like to remind you all on the platforms for our Syncfusion Flutter widget. So as of now, we support Android and iOS. In Android, we support device types like phones and tablets. The support version is from API level 16 and higher. For the iOS, we support device types like iPhone, iPad, and iPod. And the supported version is from iOS 8 later versions. Currently, we do not support Flutter for web, as it is in preview from Google itself. So we are not getting into Flutter web at this moment. But whenever it is fully released, we will get that opportunity as well. So next, I would like to remind you the minimum Flutter SDK version that is required to render Syncfusion widgets. Which is version 1.7.8, and find our documentation and the APIs and features along with the information on how to get started on our from our help.syncfusion.com. So you can go to help.syncfusion.com and choose Flutter, and you can see our getting started documentations there. And all our packages are also available pub.dev. So you can go to pub.dev, search for Syncfusion, and you can see Syncfusion platter chart gauges and calendar there. So what I have here is I have created a simple application, platter application in Visual Studio Code, and I added Syncfusion Flutter calendar version 17.4.46, and the still calendar, it is in beta version, so added beta. So this is the dependency that is required to render the Flutter calendar. So you have to add this in the pubspec.yaml file, and then move on to the main.dot file. Here I have imported the package Syncfusion calendar, and so once it is imported, just move on to the self here. And as you can see here, inside the children widget, I have added a container, and I have set height as 450, and I have just initialized the SF calendar, and I have not written any other code in this. So let me run and see what's the output here. So as I said before, you can go to our documentation page, which is help.syncfusion.com, where you can choose Flutter, and inside Flutter you can see the available controls here. So to get started with our calendar, let me move on to the calendar and click on insert the documentation here. Just load. And so those who are not familiar with our feedback portal, I highly recommend you guys visit this feedback portal. It's syncfusion.com/feedback, where you can go and choose the required platform. For example, here Flutter, and you can provide any feature request here. So if you like any widget that you like to see, you can here, and you can also have, if you have any bugs, you can add it here. So this will, and this is a public feedback portal. So anyone who wants a new feature can actually log here. And if that feature gets prioritized, or you know, these things are prioritized based on the votes that are provided publicly. So if developers choose a particular feature, and we have so many votes for that particular feature, then we can actually it will add it to our queue automatically, and prepare a roadmap based on these features and you know all these things. So so you can actually see what are the things that are available here. So let me show you what are the features that we have introduced with our radial gauge. So in radial gauge, we have provided gradient support. So you can basically set gradient for any range. So here we go. So you can basically set gradient color for any range. Earlier we can set the solid colors. Now you can set the gradient color as well. So the gradient color is very quite easy here. So all you have to do is you have to set gradient, and you have to set the sweep gradient, and you have to set the colors one by one. So this is one cool feature that we have introduced with our So finally,
Thanks. We have hot reload for this for these reasons. So once the once the application is on, we can actually change anything using our hot reload feature. So what I have planned today is I just want to show you how easy it is to get started with our calendar using our getting started documentation itself. So I'm just going to follow the steps that are printed in the getting started documentation so that you guys can actually follow along with me, so that you know it will be very easy for you to get started. So as I said, I have already added the dependencies, I have added the input packages, and I have just set the height for a child. And I will set the child as SF calendar. So there you go. So this is the new licensing model that I was talking about. We will get a pop-up. So to let me you know, summarize on these licensing model later. So as I said, we have just initialized the SF calendar, and you can see the SF calendar. This is the default view of a calendar. So let me show you how to customize all these things. First, let me show you how to calendar views. So what we are seeing is what we are currently seeing is the day view. So I'm going to change this into a month view. So to change that, we have a calendar view dot month. So you have to set the view, and you have to set the calendar view as month. So I'm just saving. So there you go. You can see the calendar is viewed in a month view. So similarly, we have month view. We have timeline of day, timeline of week, timeline for work week. So all these things are available. So let me change this to week. So the next I'd like to showcase is how to add a data source. So to add a data source, it is very simple. You have a property called data source. Then you have set the data source value. So what I'm going to do here is, here we have already created a set of list. In list, I have set the color and all these things. So let me show you how we can add this. I'm just going to copy this. So I'm just copy pasting this so that you can really see it is. So this is the week view you can see here. So let me get simple plan. And I have to have it. So I'm just, then what I have to do is I have to provide the data source. So I'm just going to provide the data source. Then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to provide month view settings. So to do that, I have to set this to month view. And I'm going to set the month view set. So what we basically did here is we have set the month view settings. Inside that, we have set appointment display mode. Appointment display mode is set to as appointment. So let me show you the output of this. So there you go. You can see we have added a particular data called conference, and you can see it shows conference, and we have provided the color for it. We have provided the color as green. So what we have basically done is we have simply created a date and time, and we have added meetings with name as conference. We have provided the start and end time, and we also provided the color for that particular appointment. So this is a simple data source that I've added here. And let's see how this can be displayed as an event, in an event calendar. So the thing I'd like to showcase you is seeing the first day of week. So we can change the first day of week. For example, in certain cases, we need this first day of week should be as Monday. So let me change this to week view. And to change the, so let me save it. So there are some cases that we want to display a particular day as first day of week. Every first day of week can be a Sunday, but in few cases we can change that. So to do that, all you have to do is you have a property called first day of week, and we have to set, it starts from zero. So zero is Sunday, and Tuesday and Wednesday. So all we have to set is you have to set one for Monday. So I'm just going to set first day of week as one. As you can see here it's from Sunday. Now it will automatically change to Monday. So there you go. You can see it has automatically changed to Monday. So this is one way of doing it. Next, I like to showcase the initial selected date. So if you want to see a particular date while loading, you can actually provide that itself. Provide that. So the particular API for that initial selected date. So I'm just going to provide the initial selected date here as 2020, the current month. And it would be 20, and that is the time that I have provided. So I'm just saving it. So here you can see it is the 18 has been selected here, but once I save this, you can see. So there you go. Now you can see here the 20 selected, and the time 12. So it has selected from 12 p.m. So this is basically. While loading itself, we can search. Then I can select an initial display date as well. So if you want to have an initial display date, then you can set initial display date here. So I'm just saving it. So there you go. Next, You can, you know, you can have different customization options for selection, decoration. So I can highlight the color, you know, I can give cell border color and all these things. So let me show you an output of that. So what I'm going to do is, you have selection decoration. I'm just going to delete these. And so this property is selection decoration of type box decoration. So inside box decoration, you have to provide the color. So this color provide this color represents the color. So I have set transparent, and I have set the border color as red, and the border radius. So you can provide quantity, and I have provided the box shape as rectangle. So there you go, you can see now it is selected, and the color is red and the shape is rectangle. Now I'm going to change it as circle. And I don't want the border radius here coming out. So as I said, these things are available here, and you can actually see these. So let me show you how to you know, view time slot views. So you can actually set time slot views. So you can set work week, and you can interval height, and all these things are available. So if you want to show appointments, the best thing is to show the appointment view. So let me show a demo on that as well. So if you want to set a spanned appointment, all you have to do is you have to create a data source, and then you have to set that to all day appointment. So here you go. You can set the start time, end time. You can add the appointments here. You can set the start time, end time, and these things are available here. You can customize the header. You can also customize the header here. You can provide height, width, and you can provide background color, and you can change the text color as well. So let me show you. In month view, you have a, you know, you can set appointment. So this is basically, you can see appointments at once here. So this is called the month agenda view. So month agenda view will show you a month and as well as the events. So to set that, all you have to do is in the month view settings, we have to set show agenda as true. So let me do that. So this is the circle that I have done. So I'm going to change that now. And I'm going to say this month. So I'm just going to say this. So let it load. So there you go. You can see here month agenda view. So you can see the month, and it is also showing the agenda as well. If you want to add our chats, then you can add Thinkfusion underscore Flutter underscore chats. And since the development environment is very slow at my end, I don't know what happened here, but it is very slow. I think I will end up the demo session here and let's move on. So as I was saying, we have introduced the licensing model. So if you want to have the perfect licensing, you should pass your key to the register license method in the main method of your project. If you are not doing this, you will get a pop-up. So you will get a pop-up that shows this is a trial version of this particular widget that you're using. So if you want to clear that pop-up, all you have to do is you have to go to your account. You can register for a license. We also have a free license for called the community license. If you're eligible for the community license, you can apply for that, and you can provide that license key here in the register license method. So in the main method, all you have to do is you have add Thinkfusion license dot register license, and inside that you have to provide your license key. So that's all from my side, guys.